welcome to the Big Fat Quiz of 2013. Of course, these days, you can't call things big and fat. So welcome to the bubbly, jolly, fully figured, enjoying life, celebrating our curves quiz of the year. The Big Fat Quiz 2013. Think of it as a slightly more up-to-date version of the Big Fat Quiz 2012. Or a slightly old hat version of the Big Fat Quiz 2014. If you'd like to play along at home, then presumably you don't have the new Xbox. Unlucky. Let's meet our teams. First up, we have a bit of fresh meat, Jack Whitehall, and he's brought some mutton dressed as spam. It's Jonathan Ross. Next up, she's the crazy stalking fangirl from Flight of the Conchords. He's a maths-loving science bod. It's like Match.com, pick the teams. It's Kristen Schaal and Dara Green. And finally, we've got a rock and roll dandy and the brains of the operation. All we need now is a ladies' man, a jock, and Jason Statham, and we've got ourselves a heist movie. It's Noel Fielding and Richard Ayoade. Jack, are you okay with Jonathan this evening?
Yeah, well, I did this lovely show last year, and I got in... Don't touch me. I got in a lot of trouble last year for some jokes that I said on this show. So I was like, this evening I'm going to behave and there are going to be no Ofcom complaints. I'm on best behaviour. And you put me with Jonathan Ross.
I'm mentoring you this year.
You're not. That's like turning up to an AA convention and your sponsor's Gaza. Like, he's going to lead me astray.
I've got some jokes I've written for him, some family-friendly jokes for Jack to do.
And so
he said
awful.
He's not going to do them, but
they're
this will keep you out of trouble and get laughs.
Well, I'm very much looking forward to hearing those. Dara, Kristen, how are you?
We're great. We're fantastic. Kristen's just over for the day.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And, sure.
I'm so looking forward to questions about British politics, British television shows. hits in the British charts over the last 12 months or so.
Yeah. This has been a great year for me. I became a woman. Really touch and go, but I think it happened.
When you say you became a woman...
Just blossomed.
OK, Richard, you look composed and ready for this.
Yeah, it's been up and down as a year. a lot of sadness. But yeah, I'm here, I'm ready to quiz, I'm ready to take a sideways glance at the events of the previous 12 months. I look like his legal advisor.
That's exactly it. Right. Could you talk me through the outfit? I mean, because, you know, Jack
is... just skate over mine.
Are you all right, Noel?
As Noel's legal advisor, it's very dangerous.
Yeah.
Where there's blame, there's a claim.
Sue you.
Don't sue me.
I've got a dress on, look.
That is a hell of a look. That's a strong look.
Nearly broke my cheekbone.
Right, round one. Round one is all about the year's biggest news headlines. Chris Hune was jailed for getting his wife to take speeding points. Whilst in prison, he was subjected to violent threats and verbal abuse. Although, to be fair, it was his decision to phone his family. In August, two young women were imprisoned in Peru on charges of drug smuggling. The girls, one from Northern Ireland and one from Glasgow, said they'd been living in terrible conditions. But now they were glad to be out and living in a Peruvian jail. Abu Qatada was deported to Jordan this year. It was the first time in history Heathrow security have let someone on the plane only after assurances that he didn't pack the bag himself. Of course, it wouldn't be a quiz without questions. Eyes down, everyone. Round one. First up, it's over to a man who made the transition from comedian to revolutionary in 2013. It's Russell Brand.
Hello, Jimmy Carr. Now, would you cast your mind back to January this year? Do you remember it came out that a certain... lasagnas and food and that meat food had horses' innards in it, like innards that had come out of a horse, a thing that the horse was when it was alive, that had become a type of food now. Iceland, the supermarket, was implicated negatively in all of that. What did Iceland boss Malcolm Walker say when he was asked whether he'd checked for horses in his food? What did he say? That's the question, Jimmy, that I'm passing on to you. Obviously, you can't ask questions directly, Jimmy. You don't have that degree of ability.
The claws are out.
It's remarkable.
Okay. Who's this man?
He's the head of Iceland, Malcolm Walker.
Did he say that the vegetarian burgers had pantomime horse in them?
No, he didn't, but it would have been brilliant if he had. OK, question number two. Which event prompted BBC news reporter Simon McCoy to say during an outside broadcast, plenty more to come from here, of course, none of it news?
Well, that's inappropriate.
outside the building
He was outside a building, yeah. Right. What was going on inside? What was going on? That's the question.
That's like the opposite of what you want
to
say.
Could that make perfect sense?
You're meant to
listen. Just think of the question.
I'm older than you. You're meant to listen.
Stop bickering,
you two. Do you know the last time me and Jonathan worked together, we did a thing where we gave out an award. I got a tweet from someone, one of the most creative bits of abuse ever, saying, Jonathan Ross is like a cyborg sent back in time to remind Jack Whitehall that he's still not funny.
Well done, trolls. OK, next up, we're going over to one of the biggest comedy stars in the world. It's Steve Carell, everyone.
Oh, wow. Hi, Jimmy. Hi. 2013's been a funny old year. And one of the strangest events occurred in February when windows in over 4,000 buildings shattered in Russia. But can your teams remember why? Can they?
Oh, the geeks have got it.
Yeah, the geeks have got it.
What?
This...
Nothing. Next question. Why did a marriage proposal in July get tweeted about by Nick Clegg, written about in the Independent newspaper and mentioned in the official parliamentary records?
Well, it got tweeted.
Wow. That's, mean, cause
that's
you know,
a big deal.
That's a big deal, yeah. To get onto Twitter,
it's
that's
got, it. It's on Twitter.
And finally, it's over to the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School in Neasden who are performing one of their unusual school plays. Can you tell me which news story they're acting out?
Trade, security, the economy.
I agree.
Ooh. I'm telling on you.
Okay, so what news story were the kids of Mitchellbrook Primary School acting out there?
Jimmy, can I introduce a little idea to maybe make the stakes a little bit higher and a little bit more fun for everyone? Is that if Noel and Richard fail to get in the top two teams at the end, that they go backstage and switch outfits?
Yes.
We are prepared to take the same bet. Okay?
No, I don't want to have to wear a cheap suit.
Dara, Kristen,
are
you up for this?
Whoa, I don't like where this is going at all.
Okay, so everyone's up for this, it looks like, Dara. Yeah.
We were doing joke answers. We're not doing joke answers now. If I have to wear that dress,
how dare you?
It's a lovely dress. I'm just saying I'm a very bit... It just won't work
just,
on me.
You should have confidence in your body.
I think if you wear it, you'll look like a massive Quality Street. It'll look amazing. Okay, time for some answers. First up, Russell Brand asked you, what explanation Malcolm Walker gave for not detecting horse meat in Iceland meals? What did you all put?
Well, we wrote nay, by which we meant he didn't. He said he'd never eaten it. He doesn't eat at Iceland.
What did you put?
He said yes.
Yes, there's horse meat, but only the best horses, only Lippinzenners.
Lippinzenners, probably.
Yeah. No poor horses.
Yeah.
OK, that's not the exact right answer. We can go now to Richard.
I check once a month when I'm in the shower. Sorry, I'm confused. I couldn't fit all of it in. I'm sorry, I'm confused. Why would you ask me if I check for horse meat? Because that would imply that I was sort of looking for it, which would implicate me. And so I'd probably try and dodge that question.
That That's almost, I mean, that's almost what he said. Have a little look at what he actually said.
Constantly testing, checking every week. Did we test for horse? No. But we haven't tested for dog or cat either. Or there might be dog and cat. You can't test for everything.
I wanted to see him list every animal we knew then and run out at puma.
And then you walk in the background, he goes, oh, crow.
OK, so no-one got that. Next question. I asked you what event prompted BBC News reporter Simon McCoy to say plenty more to come from here. Of course, none of it news.
This one we have got wrong.
What did you go for, Richard?
Gangbang inside, the whole place is going to blow.
Dara, what did you go for?
We began the opening of the old news museum.
Yep.
Oh. But that's still news.
Exactly.
Jonathan?
I don't know what Jack was thinking.
The weather. None of it means news. We've still got more stuff to come, none of it news. So that is what happened next. So
well, let's take a look.
Well, plenty more to come from here, of course. None of it news, because that'll come from Buckingham Palace. But that won't stop us. But until then, we're going to be speculating about this royal birth with no facts. Back to you, Ben.
So it was the royal birth. It was the birth of King William had George. Was this big news in America?
Oh, yes. It was a boy named George. And we're like, yay! We went back to our sad lives.
Well, let's have a little look at the royal family. Here they are. That's four generations.
Wow, he's got a long body.
George looks like there when you pick a cat up and its feet are stuck to the carpet and its body. Body goes really long.
Well, I'm not quite sure that's what's going on, but yeah, okay. Question number three. Steve Carell asked you what caused windows in over 4,000 buildings to shatter in Russia this year. Did you know?
A big old meteor.
Big old meteor caused 4,000 windows to shatter.
Oh! Yeah.
Okay, Noel, Richard, what did you put?
We put asteroid or some other space business.
Well, that feels pretty good.
That's pretty cool, yeah.
Jack, Jonathan?
We put Miley Cyrus on a ball. I thought maybe... The ball smashed the windows. But I've got a joke for Jack to do, which is kind of more family-friendly than the material he's used to doing.
OK.
Kill me now.
This is going to work for you. Support him in this stage, Jim. It could be a whole new career. The windows shouldn't have broken in Russia because they had only just been...
Putin.
All right, so well, should we have a little look? Let's have a look. Yeah, this is the meteor in question.
What's this? The asteroid.
Good tunes.
Yeah. Wow.
All right, I asked you why a marriage proposal in July got tweeted about, written about in The Independent and mentioned in the official parliamentary records. What did you get?
I thought a dog married proposed together to a cat, because that's a lovely story.
Dara, what did you go with?
We said it's a gay thing, and I put two little love hearts, but actually one of them looked like Pac-Man, so I gave him an eye. So we think it's, you know, gay marriage.
That's a gay marriage. Noel, Richard, what did you get?
Gay marriage.
Yeah.
So point for Dara and Kristen, a point for Noel and Richard. It was the first gay marriage proposal. The first ceremony is expected to take place in March 2014, and the first marriage proposal was between Ed Fordham and Russell Eagling. Congratulations, boys. And finally, we saw the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School performing an unusual school play. What event were they acting out? Did you get this?
Spider-Man.
what did you get, Dara?
Then Edward Snowden was the Spider-Man's name. Yeah. Although he wasn't actually, yeah, it wasn't his spying. He just opened up the files. So of the spies.
Of the NSA, yeah.
And people got really upset because, oh, my God, they're spying. And you're going to go...
People were mildly upset. I think with the age of YouTube and Twitter, people are like, oh, someone's watching me all the time.
Cool. Means they're actually sexy. Yeah, oh, no, NSA. Like, often when I step out of the shower, I go, who's watching now?
Like, oh,
I've
only got 2 followers, but I've always got the NSA.
Don't I? Are you there, boys?
I've got a joke for you about this Spider-Man. They locked him in a building and he couldn't get out because he was...
Snowed in.
What did you guys get, Noel? Richard?
We got Snow Down.
Snow Down, fine, near enough. Armageddon Watership Down.
I thought I saw a rabbit, but it wasn't as a child.
And I thought I saw Bruce Willis.
Near enough. I think everyone gets a point there. Everyone gets a point. Well, let's check in on the scores. Jack and Jonathan have 1 point. Count them. One. Dara and Kristen and Noel and Richard have both got three.
First.
That's all for part one. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of 2013. This round is all about the year in TV and movies. Peter Capaldi was announced as the new Doctor Who. We all have different opinions on who the best Doctor was, just like we all have different opinions on who the second worst was after Sylvester McCoy. Simon Cowell announced he's going to become a father. He's not revealed if he's expecting a boy or a girl, or indeed a group. Greg Wallace allegedly punched a man in the face at a dinner event over claims the man groped his girlfriend's backside. He wasn't annoyed that the man felt of his girlfriend, just that he said it was soggy, tasteless and with a terrible texture. Let's remind ourselves what we were watching this year. Okay, some big fat questions now. For our first question, it's over to two of my favourite teachers from Educating Yorkshire, Mr. Mitchell and Mr. Burton.
Yes.
This show's so good.
Hi, Jimmy.
Now, Educating Yorkshire was full of incredible and sometimes very moving moments. One of the most memorable was when Mr. Burton here helped Musharraf overcome his stammer.
But can you remember what technique I used?
Were they mumbling? Because it sounded terrible.
That's a Yorkshire accent. That's how, how they talk in Yorkshire.
Sorry.
They say things like tin, tin, tin.
What does that mean?
That means it isn't in the tin. Tin, tin, tin. No, tin, tin, tin. OK. So Musharraf had a stutter and one of the teachers helped him to overcome it. How did he overcome him? It's an incredible, powerful, wonderful moment on TV.
I cried so much when I watched that.
Oh, my God. Wait, in my mind?
Yeah. I cry too much.
You cry everything?
Everything. I cried at an episode of Deal or No Deal the other day. All this woman wanted was to take her daughter on holiday, and then she got a blue at the end, and I just went completely gone.
Spoiler alert, I haven't seen it.
Deal or No Deal. It is the most amazing show ever. Basically, this guy opens all these boxes and in one of them is a severed head. And you don't know which one it's going to be in.
And then you just got to deal with it or not deal with it.
Okay. Next question, very simple. What happened inside this box?
That's Mariella Fostrup, yeah?
Yeah.
It's the book show.
Oh, it's the other show you
said. Next question. In January this year, Quentin Tarantino had a fairly lively interview with Channel 4 News. But what memorable phrase did Tarantino use during the interview?
It's your handwriting. It's like a doctor's handwriting.
I know.
I'm slutty.
Yeah, I am.
You look it.
OK, next question. Joey Essex was everyone's favourite on I'm a Celebrity this year. In the jungle, he admitted he wasn't able to do two basic things. What were they? There's a point on offer for each.
Yep, got it.
Got it, that's a...
Got it?
Sure. You know, I love Joey Essex was on Splash last year, and he went up the high board and he said, oh, a bit scared up here, mate, this is a bit scary. And Tom Daly said, well, it's like a second home to me. He went,
You live here?
OK. Finally, it's over to my favourite Bake Off contestant, Ruby Tando.
Hi, Jimmy. We all had our Bake Off disasters at one point or another, but the unluckiest of all was poor Howard, who managed to lose his custard. Can your teams remember what happened to it?
You remember this?
That's not a euphemism.
No, but the way Ruby said it there didn't help anyone, did it? How did he lose his custard? Thank you, Ruby. OK. Have you all got answers?
Yeah, we did.
OK, fabulous. Mr Burton and Mr Mitchell asked you how Musharraf overcame his stammer in Educating Yorkshire. Who got this?
We went for a gluten-free diet and tickles.
Get off that board and get your tickles and talk straight!
Yeah.
No, Richard.
Prolonged sarcasm.
Jack, Jonathan, what have you got?
The answer, that's what we've got.
Took his parents hostage.
Yeah.
Let's have a look.
Breath, nice and loud, nice and proud. Can we just, right, one thing, and it's only because I watched the King's Speech quite recently, all right?
Okay.
One thing he does, right, when the... Because it's a very similar thing to you, in that you just can't get the words out. But what, one thing he does do is he makes him listen to some music, right? And then when he's listening to the music, gets him to do it again.
OK.
So, have you got your phone with you?
No.
Right, just plug it into mine. I'll put you some awful music on.
OK.
Right? Right, you ready?
No, yes, sir.
Yeah?
OK, that's right.
Go for it. One, two, three.
The moment when, after many years of hard work, that I own this is the same moment when the trees earn loose the soft arm from around you, the birds take back their language. You never found us, it was always the other way round.
Bloody hell. That's insane.
Musharraf, everyone.
What a lovely
moment. It's amazing, right?
That's
beautiful. Yeah, it's really lovely. OK, I asked you what happened inside this box. What did you get?
That box, that looks like Tron's shed.
What have you got answer-wise?
Water rafting that culminates in sexy biz.
Well, we didn't specifically know about the water rafting in there, but definitely there was sexy biz. Dara?
People doing sex.
People doing sex.
What? Yeah.
Inside the box.
In the box.
No, hold it. Were you...
It was Mo Farah.
He saw...
Mo Farah completed it.
Mo Farah was in that box. You saw him?
I've realised I was thinking of The Cube. And this is a different show, but I bet if Mo Farah did this show, he'd nail it as well.
That was the box from Channel 4 Sex Box. Let's have a look.
In a few minutes, a couple will enter this box, they'll have sex, and then immediately afterwards come out and talk frankly about what they did. To me, a panel of internationally renowned sex experts, and in front of our studio audience. Welcome to Sex Box.
They just be like, yeah, we did it, and woo! You know, and they were just sitting in the box, just like, okay, let's go.
Okay, next up, I asked you what memorable phrase Quentin Tarantino used when he didn't like one of Christian Guru Murphy's questions on Channel 4 News. Did you get this?
Yes. He said, I don't have to answer that, you're not my mummy.
I can tell you that's not right.
What?
Dara? Kristen?
It may look like I've written, I'm shutting your ass down, but that is just merely bad handwriting on my part. I'm shutting your ass down?
Noel, Richard, what did you put?
No, you said I'm shutting your butt down.
Let's have a look.
Yeah.
So you don't want to talk about anything serious?
I don't want to talk about what you want to talk about. I don't want to talk about the implications of violence. The reason I don't want to talk about it because I've said everything I have to say about it. If anyone cares what I have to say about it, they can Google me. And they can look for 20 years what I have to say, but I haven't changed my opinion one iota.
No, but you haven't fleshed it out. That's the only reason.
It's not my job to flesh it out.
No, it's my job to try and ask you to.
And I'm shutting your butt down.
So, Dara, Kristen, you get points. Noel, Richard, you get points. Woo! Jonathan, Jack, you get none there.
Unfair.
Okay, next, I asked you what two basic things Joey Essex revealed he couldn't do on I'm a Celebrity. Did you know?
Yeah. Croquet and crochet.
It's very hard to do at the same time.
And he gets confused between them, so whenever he tries to do crochet, he does it with a mallet.
Dara? Kristen?
Zip, read and write. Is that right?
It's weirder than that. OK, and Noel, Richard, what do you go for?
Make decisions and oscillate.
Let's have a look.
Don't do it. Pick your nose if you have to.
I can't blow my nose.
Can't you? Why?
I've never learnt how to do it.
Just blow, like, hold your mouth and blow.
I can't do it, I can't go like that. So I have to go like that. Things that you don't really need to know, I don't really know. You sound so stupid. Yeah, I learned to do my laces and stuff, obviously, because that's what I needed to, obviously, tie my laces up for the rest of my life. But blowing your nose, you don't have to do it the professional way, say. You can just do it the Joey way.
15, 30
minutes past nine. I can tell the time on a digital, but I just can't tell it on an actual, like a round one, what goes like that.
Wow. I retract any feeling that we were harsh.
Yeah.
This is the best TV you've got. It's inseparable.
Can I just say, really, this is really pernickety and so annoying, and I don't want to come back to it, but if you do play croquet, you do have to go clockwise to play. So technically, not knowing how to tell the time, he wouldn't be able to play croquet. If you went anti-clockwise, you'd be disqualified and you'd lose the game.
The idea he can't blow his nose is the really... Like, he can't do it like a professional. That was the amazing bit, like a pro. I can't do it like a pro. You know, these pro guys. They're good.
I book them for children's parties all the time. They come in and they do... dun-dun-dun-dun-dun, phoom, across the room.
Finally, Ruby from Bake Off asked you what happened to Howard's custard. Did anyone remember?
He piped it into Paul Hollywood's soggy bottom.
That's
just allowed, a bit of silly Radio 4 slap and tickle.
What have you got, Noel, Richard?
He just forgot where it was.
That is almost the definition of losing it.
Yeah.
Seems reasonable.
Dara, Kristen?
I think somebody stole it. Somebody used his custard in their trifle. Custard,
OK, really. So we're going to... It was Deborah. We're going to show it now. If you're of a sensitive disposition, it might be an idea to look away. It's pretty upsetting.
My custard. Oh, no.
I'm so sorry, Howard.
What's happened?
I used Howard's custard by error. We were both in the same fridge, and I forgot what my bowl was, and I've used his. I haven't used it all, but I am really upset.
Howard, this is like a recurring nightmare. So now you've taken possession of Deborah's custard.
And his own, and
I've
I'm really sorry.
I've got some of my own.
Jerry, Jerry.
More English TV gold there for you. Wow! Someone used my custard.
Oh, fucking
hell! But she didn't use it all, did she? So there was a bit
there. But he still had to go and make more.
Oh,
and it's
fucking hell! No! How did he cope?
No.
He's in the kitchen. So there can't have been any more custard there.
How many times have you made custard?
Oh!
It's really hard.
I buy it. You can get it in cartons.
OK, time now for a special bonus round about movies. Oh. I'm going to show you pictures from three of the biggest movies of the year, which have all been subtly improved. All you've got to do, tell me the names of the films, OK?
Yep.
Ready for this? Here's your first one.
I think Jimmy looks brilliant.
Yeah, that's a better haircut than what you got now. I like your hair now, oh boo-boo.
OK, next one.
Oh, my jeez.
Any hurtful comments? Just a normal picture of Jimmy at home in his onesie.
I like that haircut, too, on you.
Thank you very much. OK, and the third one?
That's quite good hair for me. That image made my orbs fizz slightly.
Your orbs?
What I'm saying, Jimmy, is if I was drunk in Camden, I would get off with you.
You look like you're coming out of a gorilla's vagina.
A tiara would not develop in a gorilla's womb. There's not the pressure to create that kind of rock.
OK, let's have a look, see what you got.
Star Trek, Behind the Candelabra. Great,
OK, Dara?
We've gone that, although I think we've misspelled it and actually written the second was Behind the Candelabra.
Very different film.
Buying the candle brown is pretty acceptable, I think. And what have you gone for, Noel and Richard?
Star Trek.
Trek 2.
Okay. Liberace behind the candelabra.
The great, great Gatsby.
Great Gatsby.
Well, you're all three for three. It was, of course, Mr. Spock in Star Trek, Michael Douglas in Behind the Candelabra, and I was Kerry Mulligan in The Great Gatsby. Let's see what that's done to the scores. OK, Jack and Jonathan have 4 points. Okay, well, Noel and Richard have 8 in the lead. Kristen and Dara with 9 points. Now, in a last-ditch attempt to inject some life into the British economy, here are some ads. I wonder if there's any sales on. Back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. This round is all about the year in music. David Bowie surprised everyone by releasing his first album in 10 years. His previous album was released on something called a CD, and you got it from a place called a record shop, which was a building you actually had to go to and you had to pay for it. It was rubbish. The Spice Girls musical Viva Forever closed after just 6 months. The problem was the casting. Turns out it's quite hard to find actresses who can't sing or dance.
Kill Jimmy!
Thank you for your support.
We're hoping that'll catch on as a kind of nationwide catchphrase.
Bonnie Tyler represented the UK in this year's Eurovision Song Contest. Bonnie wrote the song in Wales, recorded it in Nashville, and fucked it up in Sweden. Right, time for some more questions. First it's over to X Factor judge and pop impresario Louis Walsh.
Louis.
Hi, Jimmy. How are you? Now I know what it's like to be in the glare of the public eye. Just like celebrity super couple Kim Kardashian and Kanye West. They had a baby daughter in June, and everyone wanted to know what they would call her. Can your teams remember what it was?
Oh, yeah.
OK, so we all know this. Noel, let's try and get some valuable points in.
Look at Brucey.
I love that song. Don't you love that Kanye West that song, Back Bound 2, is kind of... It's like the most mental song ever, and it's kind of genius. I know it's hard to be in love. It's all like that.
You just set
and then
back
we should do it. And then she's lying on the thing.
Don't do it.
She's not that into it.
Bring out the bar.
The motorcycle.
Yeah.
And then he's going, where's he going? You know.
Is it on the motorcycle? Is it going?
Okay, if you could just come out and talk frankly about what you've just done. Next up, which controversial chart topper has been banned in 20 UK universities, led to an American dance coach being fired and a lawsuit with Marvin Gaye, who was responsible for all of that this year?
Bang in the middle of songs.
Because a lot of people.
There could be one. Bang.
They don't know what's what, but I do.
Okay, next question. Beyonce got into trouble for not doing something at Barack Obama's inauguration. Can you remember what it was?
Yeah.
The answer can't just be yes, I can remember.
You've
got to write down what it was.
You've incorrectly framed the question. I claim my point.
I don't know that one.
During the chart rundown on April 14th, BBC Radio refused to play the number 2 single in full. Can you tell me why?
Oh.
No. Yes. Okay. You're sure?
Finally, it's over to the Channel 4 newsroom where Jon Snow has a special bulletin about one of this year's biggest hits. Over to you, Jon.
An American building contractor is facing legal action after it emerged that she inadvertently demolished a residence whilst trying to gain entry. She issued an apology to the homeowner, insisting, "I never meant to start a war. I just wanted you to let me in," and adding that she just closed her eyes and swung. This is not the first time the woman's professional conduct has been called into question, as she was previously found licking tools and operating heavy machinery while fully nude.
Jon Snow there, God bless him. OK, so what hit song was Jon reporting on?
Yes. Yes.
What's the song called again?
Wrecking Balls.
Well, that's very much the question, Jack. OK.
Cute.
Well done.
All right. First up, Louis Walsh asked you what Kim and Kanye call their baby. Did you know?
Fred West.
Dara, Kristen?
It's north.
North. And Noel, Richard?
North by Northwest.
That's the full name.
So his middle name is By Northwest.
Yeah.
No, By North. By North. West is its last North name. By North.
It's no more ridiculous than the actual name, is it?
No.
It's a fabulous name. Yes, they did christen their child North. So no points for you, Jack and Jonathan, but everyone else gets one. OK, next I asked you which controversial chart topper has been banned in 20 universities, led to an American dance coach being fired and a lawsuit with Marvin Gaye. Did you get it?
Aled Jones. A lot of people see Aled on TV and they think, there he is, face of an angel, well, voice of an angel, but behind closed doors, he is absolutely bonkers.
Kristen, Dara.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What have you gone for?
We've gone for a creepy Robin Thicke.
Creepy?
Creepy Robin Thicke.
Why creepy?
He's just creepy. Look at him. You clean him with a wire brush. He's dirty, sleazy, get out of here. Yeah, he's horrible.
He's horrible.
I've really taken against him.
Really?
Really, I've gone against him.
I'm okay with him. I mean, the lyrics are a bit date rapey. I know you want it. Saying one thing, but I know.
Tart.
Those may not be the actual lyrics, but
what,
the
song called No Means Yes.
Yeah.
It might as well be known. It's called Blurred Lines. Yeah. But that, basically, the content, yeah. the idea is.
Yeah,
what was that? No. Oh, yeah, whatever.
It was such an ambiguous word, though, isn't it?
It's a nightmare for me because my name sounds like Noel. No. Northwest. Let's carry on now.
It's very ambiguous when someone says, I don't want you to have sex with me. What do they mean by that? I just don't know where you stand these days.
So let's have a quick look at Robin Thicke's Blurred Lines.
What a prick.
He's just an idiot. I don't think he's mean. I don't think he even knows what it means. He's just a fucking idiot.
I did a show where I sat next to him. I mean, his legs were, like, so thrust apart and the big bulging crotch was in your face and it was just all so unnecessary.
Oh, you know you want it.
Awful. The show I was on was Alan Carr Chatty Man, which is actually a great show. Don't know if anyone's seen it, so tune in. He does great interviews.
Yeah, but he mainly gets B-listers.
Okay. Next up, I asked you what Beyonce didn't do at Obama's inauguration. Did you know?
Yes. We believe she didn't sing. She mimed there. And I'm saying she didn't sing, but apparently it wasn't actually Beyonce because Beyonce couldn't make it, so they had to send...
Beyonce B.
I like that one. That worked. Dara, Christian?
Well, I think I got the... She lip-synced. She didn't sing.
Noel, Richard, what did you get?
Miming, singing.
Singing.
Miming, singing. That's the right answer. Everyone gets a point. I asked you why BBC Radio refused to play the number 2 single in full on April 14th. Did you know?
Because it was sheer.
Angry young man.
Dara, Kristen.
Thatcher just died and it was Ding Dong, the Witch is Dead. And they said they'd play an excerpt of it and explain why it was in the chart rather than making everyone listen to the entire thing, which is probably fair, because actually, once you've got the gag, it's a dull song.
Because it goes after 3 minutes of that, like, I get the joke.
Richard,
the witch is
dead. Richard, you got this.
Ding dong, the witch is dead.
It was Ding Dong, the Witch is Dead from The Wizard of Oz, which reappeared in the chart following Margaret Thatcher's death. Okay, finally, Jon Snow reported on one of the biggest hits of the year. Did you know what it was?
Yes.
Miley Cyrus.
And the song was?
It was the
Look at Me.
But she's on the wrecking ball.
No, Richard, you got this.
Yeah.
Christian, Dara?
Oh, wrecking ball.
Wrecking ball, am I? By my
and her sexy face.
Why do people think she's being, oh, she's awful, she's all gone sexual? There's nothing sexual about somebody going.
ramming their tongue.
Hold it, you know, do that again with your tongue, because you look a bit like a lot. If we give you the hair stuff, get your tongue out.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Let's have a look at Miley Cyrus.
I met Miley Cyrus on a show, actually. I was doing Graham Norton on the...
Is it good? That's a good show, isn't it, Jack?
It's a great show.
It's a great show to do.
She was actually very nice. It was back when she was in the Disney days. She's quite A-list.
OK. All right. Time for a very special guest. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the new landlord of the Queen Vic. It's Danny Dyer, everyone! Carter, you're the new landlord of the Queen Vic.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you think you're going to die? Because in EastEnders, everyone, they either get run over or there's a gas explosion or occasionally shot. If you had to put a bet on now...
No, I want to do an Ian Bill. I want to ask me now. I'm done. I want to stay another 20 stretch, you know what I mean?
A 20 stretch.
Yeah.
Very few actors talk about
Jimmy,
jobs
I
in
don't
terms
know
of.
What you mean.
No.
I think very few prisons are impressed by. Where did you do your 20 stretch? In EastEnders.
How was your Christmas, right, Danny? Did you have a couple of jars and get off your fucking nut?
Nice bit of goose. Yeah. Nice.
Bit of goose. That's Cockney rhyming slang for slag.
Yeah. Yeah. It is. Yeah.
Shut up. Goosey rag, slag.
It's not.
How was your year?
Good. Did a film called Vendetta. It's out now. Come out on the 23rd. It's a strong piece of work. Jack, you've seen it.
Very good. Came out on the 23rd. Closed on the 25th. Brilliant. It is really good. It's violent, though, isn't it?
It's very violent, yes.
Very scary.
Hold it. Jack's trying to get a bit tough now, but it's violent. It's violent, isn't it? A minute ago, it's all about croquet rule.
OK, come on, question time. I've got a question for us. You're the new landlord of the Queen Vic.
Yeah, I've got a suitable question. So, I'm the new landlord of the Queen Vic.
I've just said that.
I was sort of saying.
Danny, are you wearing leggings, or what they say?
Are we caught you in the middle of a Shakespeare play?
I was so busy, I was fucking hell, what's a fucking...
Can you... Yeah. Pirouette, can you make it like that? Like,
you look like you're in panto, that's all.
Panto, fuck you, I think, what? Fuck something. Fuck off.
The second half of the Nutcracker starts soon.
I think they're called jeggings.
That's a blurred line right there.
It's a bit, look, because they're quite feminine, if you want to see how a real man should dress, Noel, stand up and show it.
I must be the only person in here who's thinking these jeans are a bit baggy.
Come on, Danny, question.
Well, I'm the new landlord of the Queen Vic.
We know.
Bonnie Lanford called, she wants her top back.
Let's do it.
Right. It's not as easy as it looks. It's a right poxy question, alright.
Well, let me get this straight. You're the landlord of the Queen. Go on, go on. I'm still with you, just.
This year?
Yeah.
Yes, realistic.
Right, this year, Weatherspoons announced they're opening a new pub in a questionable location. Can you remember where? I couldn't give one fuck at this point.
OK, so you all write something down. So Weatherspoons are opening a pub in a questionable location.
Where was that? I don't
know. How long have you been on the show, though? How long have you been filming these
films? A couple of months.
Is it hard? Is it hard work?
I'm fucked, to be honest. Fucking shattered.
You need this like a hole in the head. Yeah. OK, Jack and Jonathan, what have you got?
Yeah, we don't know for sure. Albert Square next to the Queen Vic.
And then we drew a little picture of Danny.
Of the landlord.
Aye.
OK, what have you got, Dara and Kristen?
Kristen, maybe somewhere in or on the river, but we also drew a little picture of Danny.
OK, and Noel, Richard, what did you put?
Drainpipe Village.
They actually opened a pub called the Hope and Champion
on the at the services on the M40.
That's it, see?
Yeah.
Right,
yeah,
well, there you go. See you later. People.
Right, let's have a look and see what that's done to the scores. Jack and Jonathan have got 6. Dara and Christian have 14. Noel and Richard have 13. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz 2013. This round is all about the year in sport. Cyclist Lance Armstrong confessed all on Oprah about his drug use. Oprah said Armstrong was emotional and intense. Well, that's drugs for you. As well as confessing to taking drugs, the cyclist also admitted peddling. Andy Murray stormed to victory at Wimbledon in July. It was 77 years since the last Englishman won Wimbledon. Fred Perry, who had to beat Ben Sherman, Ted Baker and Ron Superdry along the way. I'm not saying Andy Murray is dour, but he took his victory champagne and put it in the fridge to save for a special occasion. OK, time for some questions. First one. In July this year, Andy Murray stormed to victory at Wimbledon, but what teenage behaviour were Hollywood actors Gerard Butler and Bradley Cooper caught doing at the final?
You should write some jokes for him.
Yeah!
Beaches are always like, oh, it was a really tough match. He's really won a lot. Oh, he's like Superman. And he goes, yeah, it was really tough. Right, a joke for him, Jimmy, you selfish fuck.
He's a lovely fella. He's dropped into Mockery twice. He's thinking for support relief for us. He's great. He laughs at himself. Lovely fella. Everything's all really...
What, are you going out with him? Why don't you marry him?
You can now.
From March, I can.
Where did you watch the match from?
I watched the match from inside his tennis bag. He didn't know I was there. It was brilliant. I was in there amongst the sweatbands and his old pants.
Handing him bananas.
Handing him Lucozade. He loved it.
It was a really tough match.
It's a very good Andy Murray. OK. Next question. How did the normally genteel Oxford and Cambridge boat race land the BBC in trouble with Ofcom this year? Have you seen the Oxford-Cambridge boat race, Kristen? No,
never. Wait, I did. I saw it on social network.
Oh, yes.
Yes,
okay.
It's in the social network. You're right.
It was in the social network.
So that, basically.
Well, it's a real thing. How did they get into trouble with the BBC? They showed coverage of that and they got
lots of things in the film, the social network, are real things. Yeah. Nobody thinks they invented, like, rowing for the sake of the film, the social network, and then ever since that film came out. Yeah.
It's not like Americans watching it thinking that's like Quidditch. It doesn't really happen.
Next, it's over to the chirpiest man in pop, Ollie Murs.
Yay. Oh, hi, Jimmy. Ollie Murs here. Now, when I'm not in the studio making records, I'm no stranger to the football pitch. But can your teams tell me what was unusual about the new signing to Doncaster Rovers reserve team this year?
So, Kristen, very much a question for you there. Doncaster Rovers, what was unusual about their signing? Come on. This must have been big news in America.
It was big news in America.
Oh, okay. Okay, so over to Christine Ahuragu for our next question.
What happened? Hi, Jimmy. Now, I've had a pretty good 2013. I won a gold medal at the World Championships for the second time, and I was named Athlete of the Year for a third time. It was also a big year for David Beckham, who signed for Paris Saint-Germain in January, his last club before retiring. But can your teams tell me what he immediately did with all the money?
Okay.
Oh, did you know that?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
No, I know a lot of stuff.
He really does.
Yeah,
he does.
Yeah, but Beckham might have got an achievement.
It doesn't look like it, but he knows stuff.
Do you know what I'd do if I was David Beckham and I had all that money and international fame? First thing I'd do, I would go up to those people that do the caricatures in Leicester Square and just buy the one of myself. You know the way they always have a David Beckham there, ready to go, as like an example? How sweet would that be? Everyone else is queuing, it takes ages to get drawn. Your David Beckham, just turn up, yeah.
One off the shelf.
One off the shelf and off I go.
I like David Beckham. He was on my show with Will Ferrell. A couple of fucking A-listers there.
he came on your show then, but 2 weeks prior to that, I definitely saw him on the Alan Titchmarsh show. He's seeing other hosts.
OK, let's get some answers. First up, I asked you what teenage behaviour Gerard Butler and Bradley Cooper were caught doing during the Wimbledon final.
They blanked Jonathan Ross.
Jonathan was there at the final and he was trying to be friends and say, oh, you come on my show. And they were like, fuck off. Yeah. They were. You were both there at that
final. We were there. Well, I was there with Jimmy.
Yeah.
We actually saw it. He worked there before. I know
you were trying to flirt with them. You're like, oh, I'd love to have you on Bradley. And they're like, I'm afraid we're booked for loose women.
Dara, Kristen.
They were jumping about and high-fiving and...
Breakdancing?
They brought a lino and they spun on their heads. They were high-fiving each other and...
No.
Oh, OK, what? Noel? No? Richard?
Necking and texting and giving each other Eskimo kisses.
Eskimo kisses?
Yes, with the nose and... No.
Could you, Noel?
Yeah, we could, but we'd just... We'd rather...
I would have done it then. You were such a slut.
You were better.
We'd rather have sex in the box.
No one wants to see that.
The answer was they were spotted actually taking a selfie. Taking a little selfie there of themselves.
Yeah. Taking a selfie, sent to Paul O'Grady saying, please let me on your show, otherwise.
OK, I asked you how the boat race landed the BBC in trouble with Ofcom. What did you put?
We put no oars.
Yeah, so they were doing it like, you know, when you're in the bath and you can't get the hot water down there.
OK, Dara, Kristen.
I didn't know. I thought nip slips.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, what's that?
So many nipples.
I'm literally
the
every
children.
Stroke. Doink. Little singlets moving to the sides.
Worse than nip slips is if your cox slips out. I mean, very much a rowing-based joke.
And you said swearing as well. Noel and Richard?
Cox did a swear.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a little bit of swearing. Oscar Zarrilla, the Oxford cock, swore all the way through.
Fair enough. But he's a cox. It's like, it doesn't matter what he says. If Claire Balding said it's time for the fucking boat race, then you could complain, but he's the cox.
Next up, Ollie Mears asked you what was unusual about Doncaster Rovers' new reserve signing. Did you get it?
He is a she.
Well, I think Dara got it.
It's a member of, I think it's One Direction. I can't be, you know, but one of those bands. Yeah.
So our answer is still valid. He is a she.
I love it. No, Richard?
One Direction.
That's right.
The answer is it's Louis Tomlinson from One Direction is their new reserve signing for Doncaster Rovers.
Incredible. Wow.
There he is.
He's the one on the right. Yeah.
OK, next up, Christine Ohuragu asked you what David Beckham did with all his wages when he signed for Paris Saint-Germain. Any ideas?
Over to Jonathan.
I think he was going to a market and he exchanged the money for some magic beans.
Victoria was furious. And she threw the beans out the window.
And overnight, a giant beanstalk grew. And young David went up the beanstalk.
He was very brave, but he was also scared because there's a giant living at the top of it. 3, 4, 5 from I smell a range of colognes.
Christian?
He gave his money to children's charities.
Okay, Noel, Richard?
He bought new shin pads. No, charity, we put, look, at the start, charity.
Or a flat screen 3D enabled TV.
I can see the charity there. So the answer was David Beckham gave all his wages to a French children's charity. But he's regretting that now. He's got to support a wife and 4 kids on his pension. And now for a bonus question, it's over to the Big Fat Quiz's Masterpiece Theatre, where actor Charles Dance is reading from a celebrity biography published this year.
Chapter 5. I sometimes have to pinch myself when I think of what I'm doing and how lucky I am. Not long ago, I was out and Stephen Gerrard, the England player, came up to me and shook my hand and was like, I love the show, I always watch it. I nearly choked on my vodka. I couldn't believe it. It was crazy. And I was like, WTF? We had some banter and I couldn't get my head round it. My legs were like jelly. Lol. By the time I got invited to Jamelia's birthday party at Mavida and swapped numbers of Pixie Lott, the most starstruck I've ever been is when I sort of met Beyoncé at her perfume launch. I love Beyoncé, but unfortunately she had a load of security around her, so I had to just look at her. Sad face. Then there was that time I was late for the Twilight premiere and ended up on the red carpet next to Taylor Lautner and Robert Pattinson. I fancy the pair of them. I definitely wouldn't say no. And I couldn't believe it was happening and that I was actually next to them. It was brilliant. Hashtag the good times.
Charles, answer. Very good. Okay. So, what celebrity autobiography was that from?
Why?
Have you all got something?
Yeah. Well, I wanted...
Okay. So, Jack, oh. You've gone for?
He went for
Baroness Trumpington of Sandwich.
Almost the opposite of that. Dara and Kristen.
We've gone for legendary cleric Bishop Desmond Tutu. It's the tech speak that gave it away.
Noel, Richard.
He put his own autobiography. It might be a double bluff. Because he didn't seem to even be looking at the book.
It was like he lived it.
It was, reading by candlelight. It was like Cyrano de Bergerac. There's no way he could have been reading the
also,
word.
That didn't even look like the book.
No.
It was leather bound.
That was something out of a jumble sale at the props department. The whole thing's a fucking sham.
Let's go back and see.
That was an extract from Secrets of an Essex Girl by Lauren Gugger. A maze.
I actually don't know who that is.
She's in The Only Way is Essex.
Ah, right.
Let's see what that's done to the scores. OK, so Jack and Jonathan have 6 points. Noel and Richard have 16. Dara and Kristen in the lead with 17 points at this stage. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This round is all about the people who made this year memorable. Tommy Robinson quit as head of the EDL, which is a shame, as I was just thinking about switching my gas and electric to them. He quit because he said there were too many far-right extremists, which is a bit like giving up Grindr because you keep meeting gay men. 17-year-old Paris Brown resigned from being Britain's first youth police and crime commissioner after tweeting about taking drugs, having sex and getting drunk. She's now head of the Co-op Bank. OK, ready for more questions?
Yes.
Straight over to the walking encyclopedia from Pointless, Richard Osman.
Hi, Jimmy. Hi, everyone. Hope you're having a good time. Now, it's a fairly well-known TV fact that because I'm Richard out of Pointless, I never get anything wrong. However, this year, the Vatican did get something wrong. They had to recall 6,000 coins they'd issued to commemorate the inauguration of Pope Francis. Why did they have to recall them? Can your teams remember the fairly major mistake that they made?
OK, so the coins to commemorate the inauguration of Pope Francis had something wrong with them. What was it? Next question. Justin Bieber had a hell of a year. He punched a photographer, he had his tour bus raided, was allegedly filmed leaving a brothel in South America, even had his pet monkey confiscated by German authorities. But how did a visit to Amsterdam prove particularly controversial? Go into all the papers, a big story.
Yeah, it doesn't mean you're obliged to read it.
I think you'll like this one.
Be that as it may.
OK. I think you know this.
I don't believe I do.
You say, I don't believe I do. You did say that.
You did.
You're in the head
subconsciously,
now.
You're That's a believer.
Good. We should write that down.
Yeah, we'll write that down.
I don't believe it. And that could be a new catchphrase.
I don't believe
it's just
it.
A Bieber.
I don't believe it. Kill Jimmy. Kill Jimmy. Kill
Jimmy. Yay. OK. Next question. I'm very excited to say we're going over to the one, the only, Will Ferrell.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, as you know, former President George W. Bush has given me a lot of great material over the years. But even I felt a pang of sympathy for him when his emails were hacked this year. The leaks revealed he'd taken up an extraordinary new hobby. Can your teams tell me what it was?
No, that's wrong.
It's correct.
It's not only wrong, it's probably libelous.
It's not. I do the politics questions, you do the silly Justin Bieber ones. That's how we work as a dynamic.
OK, next question. MEP Godfrey Bloom caused embarrassment for UKIP this year after a string of high-profile gaffes. Can you name one of his gaffes?
No, what did you do? Oh, yeah.
OK, final question. Dame Helen Mirren hit the headlines for doing something rather unexpected while dressed as the Queen. What was it?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. That is not what happened.
Yeah, it could be. I would do that.
She would have woken up.
OK, has everyone got something? We'll go for the answers. First up, Richard Osman asked you what mishap befell the set of commemorative coins produced for Pope Francis this year. Did you know?
Yes.
They were chocolate coins.
Okay, Dara, Kristen.
I thought the worst thing that you could give them would be melted down Wiccan nickels.
A Wiccan nickel.
A Wiccan nickel.
Yeah, melted
would be
down
a...
into the. The Pope's
so a witch's
coin.
Witch's,
oh, my God. Coins. Can I just say, that photo looks like baby George all grown up. That is real.
What's on the background? Is he going through a Stargate?
OK, Richard, help.
They had condoms on them.
All the coins...
had condoms on them.
So no one got that. I can tell you the answer. The answer was 6,000 coins had to be recalled because they said Lesus instead of Jesus.
is Lesus the lizard Jesus?
It's a Jesus, yeah. Next up, I asked you what Justin Bieber did in Amsterdam that proved particularly controversial. Did anyone know?
Well, Jonathan's just put Anne Frank.
Anne Frank.
Yeah,
I mean
the question was, what did he do? We need to elaborate there. He went to the Anne Frank Museum and he signed in the book saying, I think Anne Frank would be a believer.
No, no, no. Please give poor Justin Bieber a chance. He said, I do hope she might... I wonder if she might have been a believer, which is not necessarily a bad thing to wonder, especially if, as he probably was, you're off your fucking tits on marijuana.
A friend of mine went to Amsterdam and took some magic mushrooms and went to the Anne Frank Museum and thought it was like an interactive thing where it was like, where's Wally? And ended up trying to rip off one of the radiators because he thought he heard someone behind it. But it's not embarrassing because, as I say, it happened to a friend of mine.
Kristen. Kristen, do you know this one?
I do know, yeah. It's just what Jonathan said. He said Anne Frank would love him. You know, he thinks Anne Frank would have loved him. And I think that's really beautiful. And for people who are like, that's so gross, it's like, what? How do they know what she would have loved? Like, she'd be like a Bright Eyes fan or something.
Yeah, it's a fine and complete answer. Noel and Richard.
Anne Frank stuff.
That is good enough from you. What happened was, he visited Anne Frank's house and wrote in the guest book, truly inspiring to be able to come here. Anne was a great girl. Hopefully, she would have been a believer.
That's fine.
It's fine.
Also, come on, he was like 16. If my son, when he was 16, went to Amsterdam and I found out he'd gone to the Anne Frank Museum, I'd be fucking amazed. There's a lot to do in Amsterdam.
Yeah. It's a good point. That's the most proud I've been to be British this year. Because, like, last year we had the Olympics, we had the royal wedding, like, national pride was at an all-time high, and I thought we were never going to get that again. And then in February, Justin Bieber came to this island, and within 4 days, we broke the fuck up. Proud of ourselves. You should be proud of yourself.
And next up, Will Farrell asked you what extraordinary hobby George W. Bush was revealed to have taken up. Anyone get it?
Yep.
He wrote the wrong thing.
No, stalking, and then I put dash, deer, not women. So, because he's a hunter, he likes hunting, so he was stalking deer. It's a practice where you follow deer around.
That's not the answer.
You could not be more wrong.
He paints portraits of himself and of dogs, and he's actually not that bad, and I just wish he would have believed in himself and had enough confidence to become an artist before he got into his presidential phase.
If he'd only really given it a go.
Right. You
know? So same about Hitler to a certain extent.
Yeah.
If he just stuck with the painting.
How much could he have done?
You know?
He painted the portraits of himself in the bath, didn't he? In the bathroom.
Oh, that's very specific. Let's have a look at some of the paintings. It's all right. It's a pretty good dog. I mean, that's a grown man that was the most powerful man in the world that did that, so well done.
Yeah. That's pretty fucking cool.
That's all right. I give him.
No, this one's better. This next one. Look at that. Who's that in the mirror? Who's that in the mirror?
Chris Hune in prison.
Okay. Next up, I asked you if you could name one of Godfrey Bloom's gaffes this year. How did you get on?
He called women at one of the sort of breakout meetings at UKIP's party. He referred to women as sluts.
That is one of the things he did. Jonathan?
He's the bongo bongo man as well, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's the one who talked about sending people out to bongo bongo land, and we've put slut gate because we've popularised it in that way.
Okay. Noel, Richard?
He said something that wasn't racist.
And we put bongo land in the corner.
I'm presuming the one you have is when he hit somebody with a catalogue. he hit a Channel 4 reporter.
with a rolled up book. With a brochure, party brochure. That somebody pointed out there are no black faces on your montage of UKIP supporters. So you thought about it for a second and weighed up the pros and cons of the event. Just hit him. Hit him.
He hit him over the head and called him a racist. Let's have a look.
Mr. Bloom, what do you make of the front cover of this, the conference brochure with no black faces on it?
What a racist comment is that? How dare you? That's an appalling thing to say. You're picking people out for the colour of their skin. You disgust me. Get out of here.
What's appalling about racist. Making that point?
You, sir, are a racist.
What am I racist for saying there aren't,
you
there aren't
take
any
this
black people?
And you've checked out the colour of people's faces? Disgraceful. Disgraceful.
that's good great. TV.
That's TV.
That reminds me so much of my dad when he found out that our local newsagents were stocking The Guardian.
You bastards!
He also said British aid shouldn't be sent to Bongo Bongo Land.
But you know what, he is right, because if we're sending aid to Bongo Bongo Land, that's wrong because it doesn't fucking exist.
It's where they make umbongo.
Final answer. I asked you what unexpected thing Helen Mirren did whilst dressed up as the Queen. Did you know?
Scaring people in Madame Tussauds.
Ooh.
That would be so much fun.
She's doing the, whatever the play she's doing in the West End, and there are drummers drumming outside, and she left the show mid-show. I think she was in the middle of one of the acts and said, I'll be back in a minute, or whatever. I don't do the Queen's voice.
One
must go and tell some drummers to fuck off. went outside and turned old Danny Dyer on them. You fucking slags, get here, fucking drummer, fucking drum you.
And then we have to go.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Noel, Richard.
Tell drummer to fuck off.
Yeah. Well, there's right answer. I've got the direct quote, which was, shut the fuck up. People have paid fucking £100 for their theatre tickets to a group of dramas outside the theatre.
Yeah, I think she had
but
a point.
What if she'd accidentally stumbled into Stomp?
So it's that part of the show where I introduce a mystery guest. All you have to do is guess who they are and how they made the news this year. Ladies and gentlemen, our mystery guest. OK, so you can only ask questions that you can answer yes or no.
Did you get your tights from Danny Dyer?
No.
Were you in Spice Girls the musical?
No.
Congratulations.
Yes, well done.
Is your name Amanda Knox? Yes or no?
Did you appear on television?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Did you appear on it unwillingly?
No.
Was the situation blurred?
Yes.
Did you win MasterChef?
No.
Is it a cooking show?
No.
Is it
a performing show?
Yeah.
Are you the lady that operates Bruce Forsyth?
So it's a big show on television, big reality show.
Not that big.
There was a new story off the back of this. It was a huge show. It was a reality show, and there was a new story off the back of it because it was such an extraordinary thing that happened.
Have you been on the Jonathan Ross? I know it's a big show, you said.
another clue would be you were on a show, and I think it is fair to say that you were not invited.
Yes, I know you threw an egg at someone.
Yes.
Write down your answers. You've got to write down your answers.
To everyone.
You didn't say.
Hey, what was it again?
Yes.
Okay, let's see what everyone put. Jack, Jonathan, you went with?
We went with threw egg on cowl.
Threw egg on cowl.
Richard.
We just went with threw an egg at someone on Britain's Got Talent.
Dara?
Threw an egg like Jack said.
So tell them who you are.
My name's Natalie Holt and I threw some eggs at Simon Cowell.
Yeah, now.
Yeah, what's the backstory to it anyway? I never really got why you did it.
Well, I just thought Simon Cowell's got too much power and influence in the music industry, so I thought it'd be funny to throw an egg at him.
And you, young lady, were correct. It was very funny. Let's have a look at you in action.
They're unreachable. They're unreachable.
more question.
Yeah. Go ahead, Noel.
Who are you marrying me?
Holy cow!
I'm marrying somebody else, sorry.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Really good aim. You were like 30 feet away from him and you got him in the head.
I got him twice.
How did you get backstage and onto the stage without...
Well, I was booked to mime in this backing orchestra with an act that was on the show. And I just thought, well, I could...
Have you ever considered becoming a terrorist?
Natalie Holt, everyone, give a round of applause. Yeah. Let's take a quick look and see what has done for the scores. Jack and Jonathan have 9 points. Noel and Richard have 21. In the lead, Dara and Kristen with 22. Right, time for another break. Once again, Natalie, give a round of applause. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This round is all about lifestyle, the fads, fashions, technologies and trends of 2013. Grand Theft Auto 5 was an enormous hit this year. The big moral question is, does playing Grand Theft Auto affect the way one relates to hookers you've kidnapped in the real world? The Share a Coke campaign launched this year. Advertisers discovered people all over the world enjoy having their teeth dissolved by something with their name on it. Right, and for our first question, it's over to Rizzle Kicks.
What's up, Jimmy? Now as pop sensations, it's very important we keep ourselves looking ship shape. These bad boys didn't happen overnight.
Where's the beach?
One of the biggest health fads this year was the 5-2 diet, but can your teams explain how it actually works?
So it's the Rizzle Kicks. Can we have another look at the Rizzle Kicks there? One of them looks as if he might be solving a murder.
That'll be Harley.
Harley, I love the Rizzle Kicks.
I love Rizzle Kicks. They're great.
Harley. Do you really love Rizzle Kicks?
Yes, I love
you go to their gigs?
Yeah.
You wear badges?
I have never missed.
You've got their album?
I hate people who are only getting on the Rizzle Kicks bandwagon now. Because I was there when they were just starting off.
OK, next question. Have a look at this clip of a woman sitting down to a bite to eat. Why was this newsworthy? Here she is. She's eaten a bit of burger there. Why did that make the news? Why on earth would that be a story? Jonathan, what have you got? What's going on?
Well, last year, Jack had some pizza delivered. Because it's Boxing Day.
Oh, you've got some bread?
Yeah, we thought we'd make some food for us.
Oh,
yeah.
What have you got?
Oh, yeah. I've got some bread and we've got some turkey.
Last year, I ordered pizza for everyone. A lovely gesture. This year, you've brought your old turkey. Oh, thank you, Jonathan. You're so generous.
Wow.
Oh, and yeah, just go ahead with your hands.
No, but we're just... You can have some mayo if you want.
Jonathan, you want? This is the least appetizing thing I've ever seen.
Are we allowed to eat this, Jonathan?
Yes.
Are there any vegetarians here in the audience?
Stop squeezing the sandwich. What is this process?
Don't throw turkey at people.
You know Jonathan makes a sandwich, right? Jonathan puts the things between the bread and then squeezes really hard to leave it in place of his own hand.
That's called a post-Christmas sandwich.
I'm in the middle of a quiz here. What noise did you just make, Jack?
That was the bottle.
Jimmy, I've also got some presents for people. These are, and I'm re-gifting, these are unwanted gifts. So I would bring them in anyway.
Really kind of you.
That I want.
Yeah. Unwanted Christmas gift.
I don't know.
Jonathan?
Oh, I haven't seen that. Can I have that?
Yeah,
quite. Plus, you don't want to watch that.
Always.
Do you know what, Jonathan? Did you actually go out and buy 2 copies just for this?
No, these are the ones you gave me.
That's all the fun over here. Comment. I'm going to put some turkey in this.
If we put your jacket on the turkey, it'll look like it's alive.
Yeah, get it.
I think you should wear the turkey as a hat.
Look, that's the perfect present. It's a Jimmy Carr DVD with turkey in it.
Noel.
This is unbelievable.
Noel.
Yeah, what's happened?
Noel, if Dara were to put on your coat, you would look like the baddie in Despicable Me. I just think it would look amazing. We're all fans of Despicable Me, yes? Everyone likes Despicable Me.
I think you
might have to just put... Oh, wow.
Yay!
That's great. I love that coat. It's like a small scarf on me.
Your coat is like a throw for me. This is just a much better way to do television shows.
Okay.
Jimmy, why don't we carry on like this?
All right, let's carry on like this. Kristen.
Am I getting yelled at right now?
Let's carry on.
Are you serious?
I like the fact that Jonathan brought out the turkey as a bit of a gag and now has eaten half a sandwich.
Really good turkey.
Now we just look like two people who met at a festival. And a bag coming down off of drugs.
Don't keep it all right here.
That's quiz. That's quiz.
Okay, let's quiz.
Come on.
Let's quiz everyone.
I'm ready to quiz.
Okay, time for another guest question. This time it's over to astronaut Chris Hadfield.
Hey, lovely Chris.
Hi, Jimmy. Chris Hadfield here. Yes. This year I spent 5 months on the International Space Station. I had the chance to photograph and tweet some incredible images of our Earth. But what did I do just before I came home from space that has since been viewed over 19 million times on YouTube?
Okay, so Chris wants to know what he did in space that attracted 19 million hits on YouTube.
Carry on with the quiz. I feel so empowered.
Just if you could, if you could just write down.
I feel like Henry VIII.
Right.
No!
Next question!
You just hit Keith Richards in the face.
I feel like I've had a really weird one-night stand at Glastonbury and I don't know when's the time to, I gotta get back to my tent.
Okay. I would give you my number, but my phone's run out of battery, so let's maybe just call it quick.
Dara, I get yourself checked. Seriously.
Okay, so one of my favourite actors is asking the next question. It's Paul Rudd, everyone.
Favorite actors?
God, you're such a crawler.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, obviously, I'm a major news hound, and I don't miss a single scoop. One story in particular caught my eye this year. In November, 23-year-old Evan Spiegel reportedly turned down an offer of $3 billion from Facebook. Can your teams tell me why?
Final question on this one,
okay? Does anyone mind if I just have a sleep?
Just curl up.
Do you want me to spoon you?
Okay, night. Do you want to be... Wake me up in 4 fucking hours when this is over.
Good night, sweet prince.
Here's a pillow for you. Okay, you don't need me for the rest of this, do you?
No, you'll be. I'll have a little nap, but over there.
Right,
okay.
Come on.
Time for a say what you see question. I'm going to show you a series of pictures that spell out a phrase. For example, this spells Noel Field Ding.
Yeah,
good.
It's livened your desk up a bit. Because again, you've come as colours at Wimbledon, you freak.
It does look like you're standing on a giant tennis ball.
Yeah.
It's a really tough match. At one point, a ball came and I had to hit it back. Really tough.
Okay, so final question. Say what you see. So all you've got to do is say what you see here. Say what you see.
Say what you see. Say what you see. Okay.
Well, here it is.
It's a technology story, if that's a clue.
What? That doesn't even make sense.
Boom! We've got it.
Wow.
Oh, all right.
For once. Good.
Right, I'm throwing turkey at
you. No, don't throw turkey. No throwing turkey.
Hey, if that starts, we've all got a lot of turkey to throw.
I think, if there's an arms race, I think Jonathan's very much in the lead there. Okay, some answers. First up, Rizzle Kicks asked you how the 5-2 diet works. Did anyone know?
5 meals, 2 fingers.
It's got to be here, right?
That is incorrect, but that also works, but don't try it. Yeah. Noel, Richard.
2 days, no eating. 5 days, eat. Tarzan wrote that.
For every 5 glasses of alcohol, it's 2 glasses of water.
Great diet. You can get for that or like
yeah.
That. Yeah. The, yeah, 5 days eat normal eating, and for 2 days, you eat about 500, 600 calories.
That is the right answer. OK, so, Noel and Richard, you get a point. Dara and Kristen, you get a point. Marvellous. OK, next question. We saw a woman sitting down to have a bite to eat. What was going on here? Why was this newsworthy?
Now, this
she's smelling for horse meat.
See, this is the point at which I've clearly walked away from the desk. Right? Smelling for horse meat, we seem to have written at this point.
I know what it is. I just put a squiggle because I panicked, but it's a woman who was trying meat and it's been made by robots.
It was a robot. Genetically mutated.
Yes, it's genetically modified meat. It's not actually from an animal.
It was meat grown in the air.
Noel, what have you written?
Genetically modified burger.
Yeah, she was eating the world's first lab burger. The burger cost a staggering £250,000 to make.
Lamb?
Lab.
Not lamb.
Lab. Because I've had several lamb burgers, and they are delicious. Especially if you have them with tzatziki. I can give you the ingredients, and I'll get an extra point for it.
OK, next up, Chris Hadfield asked you what he did in space that got 19 million hits on YouTube. Did you know?
I put two astronauts, one cup. The one on Earth was messy.
He's on coming on stargazing in about a week, so I'm really looking forward to meeting him, and I don't want him to see that what we wrote was...
Cake farts.
Cake farts.
A big hit. Cake farts is when, preferably a woman, will fart on a cake and up close you can just see the icing vibrating. And it's beautiful, it's like watching sound, like visually. It's a big trend. So cake farts in space, boy. Feels like two cups.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
Noel, Richard?
I was over there Richard? Being disrobed.
Richard, what did you get?
I put Gangnam Style, I was upset. Noel had left.
You performed a version of David Bowie's Space Oddity. Let's have a look. This is Major Tom to ground control. I've left forevermore. And I'm floating in a most peculiar way. And the stars look very different today. Okay, next up, Paul Rudd asked you why 23-year-old Evan Spiegel turned down an offer of $3 billion from Facebook in November. Did you know why?
We didn't even hear that question. Was that when they were making love on the floor in front of us?
Yeah.
Yes.
We got distracted. That was Snapchat. But I don't know. Did he turn the money down?
Yes, he turned down $3 billion.
That's crazy talk.
Kristen, Dara, what did you get for this?
We apparently got...
They mistook him for a starving country.
So you thought they were
$3 billion. Like, oh no, I'm not a country that needs to feed all these people.
I'm just some guy with an app. So why would you need $3 billion?
I'll turn that money away so you can put it to good.
What a lovely sentiment this time of year. What a beautiful thing to say.
Okay, Noel, Richard.
What have you put? I can't even. Oh, we got this. No, we didn't.
No. No. I thought he was owed more and he was haggling, kind of.
So vague.
No, he was the guy that came up with Snapchat and he turned down $3 billion.
Jimmy, get on with the show.
All right. Put the knife down, eh? It's a lot of fun, I know. Who gave him a knife? Okay.
Who are you, Crocodile Dundee?
I asked you to say what you saw. How did you get on?
De Canon Ted Flemfist.
De Canon, which is a very popular name in somewhere. Flame
we got this. Yeah.
Doesn't mean anything.
We nailed okay. This.
Noel, yeah. Richard.
3D printed firearm.
Let fat rain.
Oh, 3D.
Yeah.
Dara, Christian.
Say 3D printed firearm.
You got it. It's the 3D printed firearm. It was the Liberator gun, which you could use a 3D printer to make. Was released this year.
De Canon Ted Flimfist. That's the guy that did it. The guy that made the 3D printer was called
De Canon
Ted Flimfist. He's from Jamaica, and his name was De Canon.
Now you've had a drink, you're getting a little bit wasted.
OK, let's get some scores. Jack and Jonathan have 9. They're lucky to even have that. And, well, neck and neck here, Noel and Richard and Dara and Christian have both got 24 points.
Ooh.
See you after the break for the final part of the Big Fat Quiz. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. This round is all about the talking points and scandals that shook the year. €1 billion worth of art stolen by the Nazis was recovered. The Nazis originally seized the art between 1939 and 1945, during what art historians call Hitler's angry period. Boris Johnson was revealed to have a love child this year. Boris has had a string of affairs with women, or as they've become known, Boris bikes. Everyone was worried about the false widow spider this year. Of course, the worst thing about being bitten by a poisonous spider is that you're probably Australian. OK, let's have some scandal questions. Our first question comes from a performance artist, Muppet and self-described weirdo, the great Gonzo.
Yay!
Hi, Jimmy. It's Gonzo here, one of the stars of our new movie, Muppets Most Wanted. And you know, as a world-class bog snorkeler and performance artist, I've been in some pretty locations, including this place here. But none are stranger than the streets of Kingston upon Thames. Can you tell me what unusual object was found by Thames water staff in a sewer under those very streets?
The great Gonzo wants to know what was discovered lurking in the sewers under Kingston in West London in August this year.
Ooh.
OK, this year, embattled mayor of Toronto, Rob Ford, faced a series of controversies, most notably being filmed smoking crack cocaine. But how did he defend himself when accused of making sexual advances to a colleague? Jack and Jonathan, what are you sitting at the back giggling?
We're going to smoke a cigarette later.
OK, next up, it's over to Strictly superstar Sophie Ellis-Bextor.
Hello, Jimmy. Well, I wore some fabulous outfits when I was on Strictly, but I wasn't the only one dressing up. In September, a mysterious costumed figure got over 196,000 likes on Facebook, which sparked a tabloid frenzy to try and unmask him. Can you remember who it is?
I can hear
so, Sophie wants to know what mysterious figure everyone wanted to unmask this year.
What serious figure everyone wanted to unmask?
What mysterious figure everyone wanted to unmask?
Mysterious figure.
There's a mysterious unmask. Figure wearing a...
Everyone. Who wears a mask?
Maybe it's the person from the cube.
Is it John Merrick?
Not John Merrick, no.
OK.
John McCrurick?
It was not John McCrurick or John Merrick. Next question. In what unusual location did a £14,000 rose garden appear this year?
Is it like a really posh accident black spot?
So, rose garden, where have you seen roses this year that you thought that's remarkable?
Oh, we've got it, mate. Okay.
What?
Move on, sister.
Have you guys got this?
I have no idea. But I'm thinking, that's a peculiar place for roses.
Finally, over to the one, the only, Harry Hill.
Hi, Jimmy. I've been supplied a question that I'm asking you as if it's one that I've come up with. In August this year, photos taken at a zoo in China's Henan province became an internet sensation. But can your teams tell me why? Why, Jimmy?
Harry Hill there. He's been enjoying Christmas, hasn't he? OK, let's get some answers. The great Gonzo asked you what was discovered lurking in the sewers under Kingston, West London in August. Anyone get this?
Yes.
Danny Dyer's legging stash.
That is not the correct answer. What did you get?
There's a giant ball of fat.
What did you get, Noel, Richard?
Wet wipes and a wad of fat the size of Canada.
Of a galleon, not Canada. A galleon.
Galleon.
Well, you're absolutely right. It was the Fatberg, a bus-sized lump of congealed lard and wet wipes found floating in the sewer.
Where is it now?
Doing the night route down to Trafalgar Square.
I asked you how Toronto Mayor Rob Ford defended himself when accused of making sexual advances to a colleague. Did anyone know?
We said he's got pussy on tap.
That's sort of the right idea. Noel, Richard?
Put blurred lines, she didn't know that she wanted intercourse.
Kristen?
They were like, you said that you would, can I say this, eat her pussy? And he was like, never, I got all the pussy I can eat at home. Like, I am full.
That is 100% correct. And let's have a look at him defending himself.
Oh, the last thing was Olivia Gondek. It says that I wanted to eat her pussy, Olivia Gondek. I've never said that in my life to her. I would never do that. I'm happily married. I've got more than enough to eat at home. Thank you.
More than enough. That pussy is just relentless.
OK. Sophie Ellis-Bexeter asked you which mysterious figure everyone wanted to unmask this year.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Jagged Man.
OK, what did you go for, Noel Richard?
He put Kojak, who doesn't even wear a mask.
That's why it's so difficult to unmask him.
Bravo. Kristen, do you get this?
We said the Northampton Clown.
And yes. That is the right answer.
Yes. Yeah.
Basically, they set up a webpage called Spot Northampton's Clown, and then they post clues as to where he would be.
Oh, Jesus, what a river. With a necklace made out of children's shoes.
OK, next answer. I asked you where a £14,000 rose garden appeared this year. Did you know?
Yes.
Yep.
Go on.
Danny Dyer's leggings.
That is not the case. Dara? Kristen?
I guess the tube, because what a happy thing for the tube. That would really liven it up.
It'd be lovely.
Okay, Noel, Richard, did you get this?
I put David Cameron's back.
Oh, oh, that was so close.
Gaga's head.
It's actually Cheryl Cole's backside.
Yes.
Oh, fuck! Oh, yeah, of course!
Yeah, but how do we know that Cheryl Cole's backside has not been in Danny Dyer's leggings?
Can you imagine on a hot day in the summer the problem he has with greenfly?
The roses look like they've been burnt.
They do look like burnt roses. They're very dark, aren't they?
Maybe she was trying to blowtorch the aphids off.
We're really getting a long view of her butt.
And finally, Harry Hill asked you how photos of a zoo in Henan province in China ended up going viral. Did you know?
Yes. Were they building boxes for pandas to have sex in?
We filmed by Channel 4.
Pandas in boxes having sex is not the right answer. Oh, Kristen.
You go ahead, Dad.
Yeah, yeah. They replaced the animals, or they didn't have animals, so they put dogs into the cage instead, pretending to be
lions.
Oh, lions.
But they looked. The dogs had a nice mane.
Yeah.
So you could be like, as a young child, you could be like in awe and have a nice trip at the zoo.
Hey, Noel, Richard, what did you get?
Oh, we got a dog disguised as lion.
Okay, let's take a look. So this is exactly the lion in the Henan Zoo in China. That is there. That is that. Let's have a look at it next to a real lion, just so you can see, just in case you forgot what a lion looks like. Jack, I think I've got a joke for you. I don't know what kind of a dog that is, but I think it might be a Shih Tzu. Shih Tzu. OK, let's check in on scores.
Okay.
Jack and Jonathan have 10 points.
You goose.
OK, Noel and Richard have 26. What? Kristen and Dara have 28, just in the lead. OK. There are a total of 8 points on offer here.
Okay.
But so we're fucked anyway.
There is no chance in hell you can come back for prize.
There's 18 points for this final question.
Okay, we're looking for three things. The biggest selling single of 2013, the most watched TV event of 2013, and the biggest selling game of 2013. And all you've got to do is get all three right and you get an extra bonus 2 points. 2 points.
Is it? Yeah.
So it's the biggest selling single of 2013 according to the official chart company. The most watched TV event of 2013, the biggest selling game of 2013. Okay. So 2 points for each and a bonus 2 points if you get all three of them. It's really between Kristen and Dara and Noel and Richard here.
We're having a fight.
Are you having a domestic?
Dispute,
yeah.
So one more answer from you and then we're there. Okay. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. This is the final question.
Don't worry.
Okay, let's see what everyone got. Let's go to Jack and Jonathan.
Everybody get up.
You got
biggest selling single, Blurred Line.
Blurred Line.
Might have the name wrong of the next one. Dara does some maths.
That maths show. That show, big, huge,
which
huge
was my favourite maths show.
And I disagreed with him the last one, but he argued me down.
The best game, Boggle.
It is a good game.
It is a great classic game.
Okay. Dara, you've got.
Dangerously, we've gone for Get Lucky by Daft Punk as the biggest thing. She disagrees.
Yep. What do you think it is, Kristen?
Blurred Lines.
You think Blurred Lines?
Yeah, it was. But there's a picture of Daft. That's what I did. I went rah rah rah. Rah 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 rah. Give me pen, I write. Anyway, I'll
give you up. You went for biggest.
I went for Britain's Got Talent final.
Okay.
And went for Grand Theft Auto 5.
Yeah.
Okay. And Noel Richard.
Blurred Lines.
Blurred Lines.
Prince George.
Prince George, the TV event.
Yeah.
Me neither. Okay.
Yeah.
And
that's what that bit with the reporter. That bit. That's the biggest.
Sure.
Okay.
Well, I can tell you definitively, the biggest selling single of the year was Blurred Lines.
Holla.
That's right,
Daft Punk are in second place. The biggest TV event of the year was, of course, Wimbledon, the final.
Maybe for viewing figures, but not for mind and
heart. OK, the biggest selling game was Grand Theft Auto 5.
Boggle.
Boggle.
So let's have a look and see what that's done to the final scores. Jack and Jonathan have got 12 points. We have joint winners, Dara and Kristen, and Noel and Richard have both got 30 points. You have to share the trophy. The first time in a big like this. You have to share this. A big thank you to our amazing panel, all our special guests. And thank you for watching. I'm Jimmy Carr. This has been the Big Fat Quiz 2013. Good night.
Kicking your Boxing Day right in the baubles next tonight, Alan Carr's got a chatty man Christmas special.